Seismic measurements taken during raw material exploration produce huge amounts of data. These types of large-scale surveys are also called acquisitions. In a typical marine acquisition, areas of several thousand square kilometers can be studied, a process which can take several weeks. Here, air guns, that means underwater sound sources, radiate hundreds of thousands of acoustic signals in these type of large surveys. An air gun shot is often recorded by a few thousand hydrophones. They are characterized by sampling intervals of just 2 milliseconds and even less for detailed measurements. This level of fine temporal resolution is required for mapping the surface at a high spatial resolution. For 10 seconds recording length, this can result in several hundreds of megabytes of seismic data per shot. A whole survey can easily produce data volumes in the order of many terabytes. In order to obtain a single image of the subsurface from this large amount of data, the measured signals must be prepared, combined, and the relevant signals must be amplified. This is the goal of seismic processing. Hello and welcome. In this video, I will give you an introduction to the data preparation of seismic reflection measurements, namely processing. Here I will show you what steps are needed in order to reduce the large amounts of data from the seismic measurements to an interpretable image of the subsurface. The first step is pre-processing, or in other words, the initial steps of data preparation. This mainly concerns the reading in of the data and the merging of the information to the measuring geometry, the checking and the sorting of the data, and the correction of geometric plotting artifacts. Pre-processing removes the effects of all known subsurface properties from the data. In the following steps, the unknown rock information can then be amplified. Processing represents a component of seismic data acquisition. You can see how it proceeds here. A source generates seismic waves that propagate through the Earth's subsurface. In reflection seismics, as the name suggests, one is restricted to analyzing body waves that are reflected on the rock layers. Other types of waves, such as refracted waves or surface waves, are ignored. At the Earth's surface or on the sea, the waves are measured by geophones or hydrophones before they are processed. Afterwards, they can then be transformed into an image of the subsurface. In a last step, the raw material survey is interpreted. The main objectives to data processing are, firstly, to amplify signals by removing undesirable components. Secondly, to optimize resolution in time and space. That means both in the seismogram as well as in the depth profile. And thirdly, the placement of the seismic signals to a specific position in the Earth's subsurface. Processing in turn consists of many different steps. The first part of it is the so-called pre-processing, in which the data is prepared for further processing and undesirable known data characteristics are removed. In the following, I will show you some of the important steps of pre-processing. Given the many terabytes of data, it is important to check the data quality and also to verify the sorting of the data using measurement protocols. Firstly, the data is read in from the file. Then it is provided with geometry information before it is checked for completeness and defects. This process is called editing. That is the checking of the data and the cleanup of any poor quality seismogram traces. An unwanted property of the recorded seismograms is the reduction in amplitude with increasing distance. In the simple case of a homogeneous hemisphere, seismic waves propagate in a radially subsurface. Their energy is distributed over the surface of a hemisphere A, with a size 2 times pi times the radius r squared. The energy is proportional to the square of the distance. Amplitude correction restores the signal strength, lost as a result of geometric propagation losses. Late arriving weak signals are thereby amplified. This is referred to as gain recovery. Since the size of the decrease in amplitude can be estimated, the reduction can be corrected. It should be noted, however, that with this type of simple correction, interfering noise signals are also amplified. this can be removed by more complex corrections or in later steps of processing such as decking. Local effects also affect the seismic data and must also be removed. These include, for example, static corrections for the topography and the topmost layers of rock, as I will show you now. They are particularly important in land seismics. At sea, however, the tides and variable sea wave velocities must be taken into account. Here you can see an example of a vertical section through the earth. Geophones are placed on the surface, while below that a weathering layer is present. Such layers usually have a very low propagation velocity for seismic waves. They are not of interest for the purpose of exploration, since raw materials are present in deeper layers. For the travel times of the seismic waves, this means later arrivals for elevated stations and earlier arrivals for deeper stations. On the other hand, geophones on a thick weathering layer will systematically record later arrival times than those positioned on a thinner layer. The propagation velocity of the weathering layer and the rocks underneath is assumed to be constant. These are measured together with the corresponding thicknesses in additional investigations. By static correction, then the travel time effects of topography and the weathering layer are back-calculated on a reference level for all seismogram traces to the so-called reference datum, which, in this example, is this line. In addition to these static corrections, there are also dynamic, or in other words, time-dependent corrections. They are dependent on the depth of the reflectors exactly where the seismic waves are reflected. This includes, for example, the normal move-out correction. For curved reflectors, it corrects the travel times of reflected waves to those of a vertical ray path. This correction is part of the velocity analysis. Now you have learned the most important corrections of pre-processing. Using them, the effects of all known subsurface properties are removed from the data. In the further steps of processing, the desired unknown rock information can then be amplified. I will now show you these steps in a brief overview. First of all, let's look at deconvolution. Deconvolution sharpens the signal and increases the vertical resolution in the subsurface. The velocity analysis determines the average propagation velocity of seismic waves from the seismic data in the area being surveyed. This is followed by the stacking of the data. For this purpose, the individual pre-processed seismograms are added, whereby coherent signals are amplified. The stacking not only reduces the amount of data, but it also improves the signal-to-noise ratio. A seismic profile therefore represents the arrangement of many stacked seismograms on top of each other in a single image. The reflectors are, however, still assigned within the time range of the seismogram, and neither to the true depth nor their lateral position. These three steps, deconvolution, velocity analysis, and stacking, are in practice often applied repeatedly, since the results mutually influence one another. For example, improvements in the velocity model will also bring about improvements in the stacked seismograms. In general, the individual steps of processing are flexible. Depending on the application, the order in which they are used can be varied. The last step is always migration. This maps the stacked waveforms of the seismic profiles to their true reflectors in the depth, and in this way allows an interpretation of the geological structures. These then establish the basis for actually finding the raw materials. In this video, I have listed the most important steps of pre-processing and have given you a brief overview of the further processing involved in reflection seismics. You've also learned that often large amounts of data must be checked and cleaned, a process referred to as editing. The amplitude correction makes the effects of the geometric propagation losses reversible by amplifying the signals dependent on the distance. Static corrections remove known influences of the terrain topography and the weathering layer from land seismics data, as well as, for example, tidal effects in marine seismics. Dynamic corrections remove time-dependent effects. At the end of the pre-processing, seismic data remains, from which all the known effects of the subsurface have been removed. In this way, in the following steps of the processing, the location of the reflectors can be determined and a geological interpretation of the subsurface can be made possible.